Okay guys, we're back at it. We got another update for the garden. It's raining, so we're gonna be fast. Derek, me, Bush Troopers, At Home Organic Farms. Whew, we're gonna hurry. Okay, let's go.
All right, so we're coming to the end of the season for your for tomatoes and cucumbers. So what we gotta make sure that we have happen is that all of the cucumbers that exist, or all of the tomatoes rather, that exist on the plant right now, we wanna make sure that they ripen before the frost starts coming. As soon as the first frost hits, they're all gonna die. So what we do is we start to take the tops of the plants off. I know we wanted to do it anyways to make sure it doesn't go above the fence line, but what we're doing is instead of taking off the suckers and the remaining parts of the plant, are making sure that the rest of the energy drives into ripening up the rest of the tomatoes out of there. So if you see any flowers come up, if you see any new branches come up on any of the plants, take them off and we'll deal with it that way. We've got some side shoots of broccoli coming up. As you can see, you took the main stalk off. Mm-hmm. So some other side shoots are coming up, which is very nice as well. So this is probably going to be the last real crop that you're going to get your hands on, is going to be these five here that you'll get out of this plant. The rest of it's going to be all leaves, so make sure that once you harvest these ones, you can get them out. I mean, these small suckers.
Take out the whole plant?
No, take all the leaves off.
Okay.
All the leaves off, eat the leaves, and then the rest of the plants will come out as well. See, you've got some side shoots coming up here too. Yeah, see how they're starting into flowers?
Yeah.
That means they're getting into the seed production. I bet you didn't know that broccoli heads are actually flowers and seeds.
Probably well, not. Well, I found out, but I didn't know you could eat them.
Sure.
Because I just saw you eat it, and I threw away a big batch.
They're tasty.
Oh,
amazing. And they smell really nice, too. So here's another batch. So this is a small sucker. So what you want to do is make sure. So this guy will produce a head. This guy you should eat.
Right now.
Right now. So you see how you've got some little suckers that are coming up in here? That's fine. These guys will come up, so let them grow a little bit more. But same sort of deal, right? Like usually with broccoli, you get one good main head, and then the rest of them probably, and then the rest of them not so much, right? Uh-huh. So what you want to, here's one here, another one, this one maybe. So leave them to come up. They are cooler season, so they'll tolerate some cooler temperatures. But when it really starts to get into the cold weather stuff, then you're gonna have to, they won't last much longer. So when you harvest these last little bits that are the suckers, because when you've harvested the main ones, get the rest of the leaves off, pull the rest of the plants off, and you're done.
Okay.
This kale's coming along nicely. I hope you're eating it. Same with the kale. The baby
I am,
stuff is
actually,
coming
yeah.
as well. That's good.
The baby what, sorry?
The baby kale. See, there's baby stuff that's in the bottom here. That's coming along nicely, which is good. You've got
the beets. I want to talk about the beets, yeah.
Okay, beets are coming along nicely, which is good. You can probably thin some out a little bit. See how you've got kind of clumpiness of them?
Mm-hmm.
So there's a beet right there that's coming up. So what you want to make sure that you have happen is that they have enough room to grow. And so they're getting a little thick in here. And so that's going to cause a little bit of problems, right? So can you see right here? You've got one good size one.
Mm-hmm.
One good size one and one small one. That's because this guy didn't have as much room to develop. So what we'll do is pull him out, put him somewhere else.
Well, that's pretty easy.
Yeah. So I mean, you can do one of two things, right? You can thin them out, which is fine. And you can transplant them just so that they get a little bit more room to grow. And the more room that they get to grow, the better they're gonna do. See, there's another batch in here, right? See how there? It's not coming along as nice as I would like because there's not enough room. There's not enough room for the rest of these. Now, there's nothing wrong with you just thinning them out, right, and just eating the beet greens.
Mm-hmm.
That's perfectly fine. So don't think that you always need to wait for beets. You can just pull out and eat the beet greens, which is perfectly fine.
Okay.
What else have we got going on? Leaves.
Yeah, there's lots of leaves.
These beans, unfortunately, haven't done great. We've got some lettuce that's coming up. Not great. So we'll put some more lettuce in.
Okay.
And see how we do with some more lettuce. some rockets coming up nicely. There's some arugulas coming up nicely. And we got here more lettuce. And
I've been plucking cucumbers and tomatoes like crazy.
Good.
I've been having loads of them.
So this is a big deal, right? So what you gotta do is when you're coming over, come over this side. Okay, see this whole thing right up here?
Mm-hmm.
So see how you got batch of tomatoes and then branch?
Oh, and
batch of tomatoes, yep. Branch. Okay, yep. So this branch has to come off.
Okay.
Because what's gonna happen is that this plant is gonna continue to grow and gonna continue to keep going, and we don't want that to have happen, because all they're gonna do is keep putting energy into flower production and continue to keep growing, which we don't wanna do. So see, we've got two babies up here.
Yeah.
This is as far as we wanna go with that. So what you gotta do is make sure that you're walking around and you're basically following your sucker lines, making sure that you're not getting any additional leaves, because when you do, those are all plucked. When you do, it zaps energy from the plant, and you won't get the rest of it. You'll just get green tomatoes, which kind of blows.
Right.
Or which is not as... Let's edit that out. it's not as productive as it could be. And seeing as we're getting into cooler temperatures at night and potential frost range, we want to make sure that we can get as much as we can out of the plant.
Okay. How are my doors coming along?
Pardon me?
The doors, the shutters?
Doors are coming along nicely. I just want to firm up your measurements today, and that way in the next kind of week or so, I'm going to get the doors built, and then we'll bring back, and then we'll start it up. So we're not going to put the doors in until kind of this stuff starts to die, because remember, it's going to be really warm underneath there, and mm-hmm. we can, with the cold frame, delay the planting of the rest of the vegetables, so some salad greens and some of that stuff, we can delay it a little bit. So, in 2 weeks or so, once we start getting a hard frost, the cucumbers and tomatoes are going to die, that's fine. The kale will likely come out, although the kale's going to get super, super tasty after a hard frost, so I want to make sure that you leave some of it until we get hard frosts. First couple of hard frosts, you're going to be amazed at how sweet and delicious the kale becomes. Broccoli's going to be done by then. These are probably going to last at least, 2 weeks from now, that's fine. Tomato plants will be done. The beets, we're pretty much going to harvest everything, turn the soil, get a little bit more nutrients in it, put the doors on, seed the whole thing, and then we're going to start it up again.
Okay.
But we're going to, 2 weeks kind of max. We're not, around the middle of October is going to be the maximum range that we have to getting the cold frame on, because it'll be difficult to get temperatures and sunlight time.
Right.
And water.
So that basically is our extremely fast update. We should try and do that more often.
Do you want to talk about the white mold from the...
Oh, yeah, yeah. We'll talk about this really quick.
Okay, so this stuff here, this is all powdery mildew. Zucchini and cucumbers are very, very susceptible to it. Lives in the soil, it's kind of a pain. It's fairly tricky to deal with, but seeing as this is an organic garden, what we can do is we can brew up a really strong batch of chamomile tea, which is a natural fungicide. Spray the plant. If we catch it early enough, that's fine. But we've only got two cucumbers left, maybe three. So let's leave it. The fruit is falling on the plant, so it won't harm the plant. It will prevent any further growth, and it will kill the plant that exists as it is. But it won't get any bigger. But hopefully, we can get a little bit of ripening of the fruit that's already on the plant as it is. But chamomile tea, as soon as this stuff starts to show up, you start to get a little bit of yellowing. Chamomile tea. Spray the plant as much as you possibly can. It'll usually take one or two applications, and then. And then it'll help save the plant.
All right, so this has been another fast update on my organic garden. You're watching bushtroopers.com. Dave Hensman, take care. Oh, and that was Derek. Bye, Derek.